Hello everyone, I am Bandula Besinghe from Zenith Immigration Lawyers. Do you have to get the assistance of a consultant or a lawyer in the Canadian Immigration Application Service? Let me explain this way. When you are sick, what do? Normally, you go to a doctor. However, there are some who may Google search and find medicine, or go to a pharmacist and ask him to give you some medicine. Also, when you have a case in a law court, either you can hire a lawyer or you can represent yourself in the court without a lawyer. Likewise, in this process also, you do not have to get the assistance of a third party for a fee. It is not a must. Now, however, if you get such third-party assistance, you have to be extra careful, because there are so many illegal operations, especially in Sri Lanka. In my 20-year-long history in this field, I have seen so many people who have got caught to such illegal operations and come to me for my assistance, but most of the time we cannot help them because the damage has already been done. Now, there are two main illegal operations. The first one is most of the time easy to identify. They don't have any affiliation with Canada. They would say, "I am licensed, then I can provide you the service," and they may have the knowledge. However, by asking few questions, you can identify them, and you can save yourself from so much trouble. Now, few questions you may ask: can you show me your Canadian permanent resident visa or Canadian citizenship? Because in order for somebody to provide this service, that person must be a Canadian permanent resident or a Canadian citizen. Now, the other category is, there are certain Sri Lankan companies, individuals, even some Australian migration agents pretending that they are properly authorized or they work with Canadian licensed consultants or lawyers, and they may show somebody's name, and when you check the registration details of that person in Canada, for example, Immigration Consultants of Canada Regulatory Council membership, and they may show you that, okay, our consultant is properly registered, now you can see his name, we are working with him, or in a website of one of the Canadian bar associations to show that that person is a Canadian lawyer. Now, these kind of operations become illegal most of the time, because they only show that kind of affiliation, but they provide the service by themselves. Now, Sri Lankan companies or individuals cannot accept money on behalf of a Canadian consultant or a lawyer. The client has to pay the fees direct to the Canadian consultant or the lawyer into his or her account, and also the agreement has to be signed between the consultant, Canadian consultant, and the lawyer, not with the Sri Lankan company or an individual who operate under the pretext that they are properly authorized and they may have beautiful offices to lure you. Now, according to ICCRC regulations, the consultant must provide the service direct to the client. Sometimes they may use their well-trained employees, their own employees only, under the direct supervision of the consultant. Sri Lankan agents or Sri Lankan individuals cannot even provide advice to a Sri Lankan client. Everything, all the information, all the services must come from the Canadian consultant. So this is where you have to be very careful, because there are so many illegal operations. They operate under the pretext of legality, and they may show you license and they may show you other proof, but such operations are illegal.